At the beginning of the year, we got a first look at the ROG Phone 8 and 8 Pro. Here are my first impressions. Asus has one of the best mobile devices for gamers, although unfortunately they have not yet decided to sell it in Mexico, so we will have to keep waiting. The design has things we would expect from other gaming devices. For example, the standard model has LED lights on the back cover with different colors to illuminate while you are playing. But the Pro model has a small board with 341 programmable LEDs to not only help you project the Republic of Gamers logo, but also anything else you want. And it even serves for some notifications. So it's not just an aesthetic element of the design, but also an important element of functionality. One thing where these devices may stand out over the Red Magic is that they do have IP68 certification. So if they do get dropped in water, they will have a good chance of surviving. And another important detail is that this new generation is more compact, thinner, and lighter. That's always nice to have a comfortable device to play with. And to enhance the gaming experience, it also has air trigger controls, which are touch triggers on the side of the device that will allow you to play in a more advanced way. And through software, you can map any button to link to the trigger, and you can even create gestures with the gyroscope to activate other buttons in the game, so you gain a lot of versatility. In fact, they have an accessory called Aero Active Cooler, which in addition to cooling the mobile device through a powerful fan, adds two more physical buttons so you have a huge amount of controls over your game. And to have the maximum speed of response on these buttons, note that this device has two USB-C ports, the traditional one and another on the side. An idea that I think is great for this type of device, and it is strange that Red Magic has not yet imitated. The suite of software options it integrates also looks very extensive. There is one called X-Sense that through artificial intelligence promises to help you in the game, recognizing patterns, elements, and conversations. It also uses AI to automatically record your highlights and gameplays. And in terms of hardware, it features the Snapdragon 8 Gen 3 processor and multiple cooling layers, such as a graphite sheet, vapor chamber, boron nitride, fast cooling driver, and another graphite sheet. This, in conjunction with its external fan attachment, can give an elevated gaming experience, although I would love to compare it against the integrated fan that the Red Magic 9 Pro has. And despite being two models in this series, they are actually very similar, having differences only in RAM, storage, and back cover design. Their screen is 6.78 inches AMOLED with full HD plus resolution and LTPO technology to vary its refresh rate from 1 to 165 Hz. They come protected with Gorilla Glass Victus 2, and its peak brightness is 2,500 nits. Without a doubt, this device feels like a gaming-focused flagship and not just a gaming-focused mobile device. Another example of this is demonstrated in the camera section, where we will find the main camera of 50 megapixels with a Sony IMX890 sensor. That is, one of the best sensors of the moment. In addition, it has optical stabilization, so the quality should be high. It also integrates a 13-megapixel ultra-wide camera, and the third camera is 32 megapixels with 3 equis optical zoom and optical stabilization. In addition, its aperture is f2.4, so it definitely looks like a completely superior photographic system to what we have seen in Red Magic devices. Even the front camera is 32 megapixels, and not being under the screen as in Red Magic, we will have a completely superior photo quality. It also has 5,500 milliamps of battery, and 65 watts of wired charging, and 15 watts of wireless charging. This last element, again, is not present in Red Magic devices, and so here it feels like a high-end device. Finally, the highest version has 24 gigabytes of RAM and a terabyte of storage. So there is no doubt that this is one of the most advanced devices for mobile gaming. Hopefully soon we will be able to test it in more depth, because for the moment we have reached the end of this video. If you liked it, you know you can tell us about it, and we'll see you next time.